So if we go back now to our question, are threats useful? We realize that the answer is not so simple. We cannot simply say, yes, threats are useful. We know that the answer of the question will depend on the metrics that we're interested in. Also, it will depend on the workload. We saw in the toy shop example where we compared the boss worker and the pipeline model that the answer as to which model is better depended on the number of toys that need to be processed, so the number of orders. So in the toy shop example, depending on the workload, the toy orders, and the metric we were concerned in, it led us to conclusions that a different implementation of the toy shop, different way to organize its workers, was a better one. If you look at other domains, for instance, if we think about graphs and graph processing, depending on the kind of graph, how well connected it is, it may be suitable to choose different type of shortest path algorithm. Some shortest path algorithms are known to work well on densely connected graphs, whereas others work better for sparsely connected graphs. So again, the workload is something that we're interested in. When comparing file systems, maybe what's important to consider is the pattern. So some file systems may be better for predominantly read accesses, whereas others are better for more of a mixed workload where files are both read and updated. The point of looking at all of these is that across the board, both for the first question as well as in these other cases, the answer of whether something is better than an alternative implementation or an algorithm, it's pretty much always, it depends. Depending on the file pattern, depending on the graph, depending on the number of toy orders. So similarly, the answer to are threads useful isn't really going to be a straightforward yes and no one. It's really going to depend on the context in which we're trying to answer this question. And while we are at this it depends answer, you should know that it's pretty much always the correct answer to a question in systems. However, it's never going to be an accepted one. I will not take it as an accepted answer in this course either. For the remainder of this lecture, we will try to answer specifically whether threads are useful and when are threads more or less useful when comparing a multi-threaded based implementation of a problem to some alternatives. I will also provide you with some guidance on how to define some useful metrics and how to structure experimental evaluations so that you can correctly measure such metrics.